you watch the TV show The Lion Guard, you might have heard two familiar hyenas from the Outlands. These hyenas in particular are none other than Jasiri and Janja. For the past 2 years, they had helped a fellow animal friends with difficult situations and became friends with many. In need of a break from the stress of the Outlands, Jasiri and Janja came to visit the railway for the weekend, and almost all of the engines had given them the warmest welcomes.
Good morning, hyenas!
Hello there!
However, one did not.
It is such an honor to have your presence on this railway, Minister Jasiri. We never usually get unique animals with such prestige as you.
Thank you kindly, Mr.
Max. Max the Thompson L1.
Okay then, Max.
Hey look! It's one of our tank engines, Ernest!
Hello there. What was that?
The little bugger wished us.
But why?
No idea. We'll be giving him a good talk.
Max took the hyenas to the branch line sheds where he saw Ernest resting. He hoped to nip his problem in the bud.
Oi! What the hell are you playing at? Why did you wish us back there?
Ernest rolled his eyes.
Why are you allowing these things to stay? I don't like them here. Why? You heard about what hyenas can do? I fear they're set in a trap.
What are you talking about? What trap?
Don't try to play dumb with me. I know how you operate. And I know that how you're treating our guests is...
not the Great Western way.
Everyone looked over to see Duck the Great Western Engine and Billy the Jinty reversing into the sheds. And by the look on their faces, they were not happy.
Ernest, why are you being a bully to these poor hyenas?
I'm not bullying once again, my dear brother. I'm merely taking a stand.
Ernest, there's a difference between taking a stand
and just being an outright jerk.
Which is what you're currently doing at the moment? You think Jasiri and Janja are like Shenzi and Alot? Wrong. They're a complete opposite.
Say what you will, but I'm just stating the facts. These two brutes are nothing but slobbery, mangy, stupid poachers.
Ernest, how dare you say such things? I thought you knew better. It's time for your next train, so I suggest you leave right away.
Ernest scoffed and went off to collect his train, and his only reply was a disgruntled peep.
Oh, Ernest is in for trouble. I can sense it in my frames.
But the way he's treated Jasiri and Janja, I wouldn't be surprised.
Hello?
Well, hello there, little guy. Who might you be?
My name's Bambi. I'm the young prince of the forest.
So, it's true. It is such a pleasure to meet you. I'm Jasiri, Prime Minister of the Outlands.
Wow, what a status!
Hey, Jasiri! Oh, who's this little squid?
This is Bambi. He told me he's the young prince of his forest.
My father's the great prince as well.
Oh yeah, Kayan told us about him along with stories about you.
Narrowly avoiding a hunter's bullet.
And saving a doe whilst fighting off an army of bloodthirsty dogs. You must be the luckiest fawn we've ever met.
And probably the bravest too.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Of course, it was my rival, Rano, that caused Mina to get her leg caught and set off those bells. And with him being the coward he is, he left me-
Ahem!
Oh, great.
Oh, hi, Ernest.
What do you think you're doing? Putting yourself at risk talking with these brutes? Good thing I was passing through.
What do you mean? Jasiri and Janja were only saying hello to me.
Do you even know what they can do to you? The minute your back's turned, you'll be nothing but shreds.
If that was our goal, we'd achieve it long before you arrived.
Ernest interjected.
You don't think I know your tricks? You're just waiting for the right opportunity to have Bambi as pain for supper. But you can't fool me.
And you can't be blocking this line. Aren't you supposed to be delivering those supplies for the new branch line instead of telling whoppers?
Well, you are...
Don't go getting your frames in a knot.
Oh, shut up, you tart!
Sorry about Ernest. He's more of a prat than usual.
It's not your fault. It's how some people feel hyenas.
Quite stereotypical, if you ask me.
What's stereotypical?
Oh dear, another big word. It's a bit difficult to explain, really.
Just for the record, old boy, you might be overreacting a bit.
Oopa!
Before long, he went off with his goods. He chuffed down the branch line, making good time. He appeared out of a tunnel when suddenly...
I knew it!
Before his crew could check him, Ernest started to rapidly pick up speed.
Boy, slow down!
But Ernest wasn't listening.
Wow, where did you learn to do that?
Well, here's the thing. I really didn't learn it.
How so? Surely there must be a reason.
Because I was the founder of Disney.
Really?
No, I actually have no idea why.
And of course, Ernie has to barge in.
He seems to be coming fast.
Suddenly, they saw Max coming from the other direction, on the same line.
What's going on here?
Then everything happened at once.
Ernie, who cares?
Stop! Stop!
You just ruined a perfectly good meat delivery thanks to your foolishness!
Hey guys, I'm back. Is my train re-
Oh my god.
It wasn't long before the breakdown train had cleared up most of the wreckage. Ernest's wheels weren't too damaged, so they lifted him back onto the rails. Daniel was very cross when he arrived.
Ernest, I am ashamed of you. I expected kindness and an open mind from you when our hyena guests came to visit our railway. Instead, your unnecessary overprotectiveness has so far made their stay a living hell, and you recently ruined an important delivery of meat. What on earth were you thinking?
I'm sorry, sir. I was so paranoid about Jasiri and Janja hanging out with Bambi all the time, and I was afraid that they were going to try and eat him at the right moment like the rest of the hyenas do.
Daniel was livid.
My engines don't discriminate! You were so opinionated about Shenzi, Banzai, and Ed that you let their past actions get in the way of your duties. I appreciate the fact that you were only trying to keep Bambi safe, but you should have come to me and spoken to me when you had a small problem before you turned it into a much bigger one. That is what I'm here for.
Ernest couldn't muster up a response. He sadly looked down at his buffers.
The works are currently full at the moment, so you can stay here until they are ready. When you are mended, you will report straight to Volpiney Station for pilot work as punishment for discriminatory behavior. I will not tolerate discrimination on my railway.
But, sir, you wouldn't—
Silence! You will do pilot work until you learn not to be judgmental and overprotective. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir. Crystal clear, sir.
Good. You will be remorseful by the end of this, and perhaps it'll teach you not to be so overprotective.
For the rest of the day, Ernest sadly sat on the siding, watching the trains go by, wishing he was one of them.
Such a light breeze.
Ernest knew right there and then he was in for a long